Yo, what's going on, guys? It's your boy Inheritor, and welcome back to some more Detroit Become Human. A lot happened in the last episode. I didn't really talk about the last section that we did, in terms of what I was thinking and whatnot. It's definitely a different vibe than what else we've seen so far. But I'm not gonna spend too much time thinking about it. Let's just move forward.
Todd? Dinner is ready.
Yeah, I'm coming.
There wasn't much in the kitchen. I did what I could.
Life's funny. I lost my job because of androids. Then when I need somebody to take care of this goddamn house, what do I need? Go out and hire a fucking android. What a joke. Of course, androids are so fucking wonderful. Fail.
Stop moving around, for Christ's sake! You're making me nervous!
Hey, I guess I can't go on with this war.
What's your fucking problem? Not the life you dreamed of, eh? Maybe you think this is easy. Maybe you think it's my fault we live in this fucking shithole. My fault your fucking mother took off! You should stop taking drugs, Todd. Sometimes you really scare me, Todd. Fucking bitch took off without a word. Fucking whore walked out on me for a fucking accountant! It's all your fault.
Daddy, no!
It's all your fucking fault! Come back here right now! Yes! It's all her fault. I know it's her fault. I gotta teach her. You stay there. Don't you dare fucking move, or I'll bust you worse than last time. Without a word. I could have been happy. I could have had a family. But no! She didn't give a shit about how I felt.
Am I just
Everything
seriously
I could
supposed
to, make
to sit
her
here and not
move? I just wasn't good enough for her! Fucking brat! Oh, it's all her fault! I'm gonna teach her some respect!
Can I actually move without screwing something up? Oh, okay. Going. breaking out of the, what her program said. Okay. Oh, no.
Get out of here. That's an order. You hear me?
No. I want you to leave Alice alone.
You want? What do you mean you want? You don't want anything. You're just a goddamn piece of plastic. I think you got a problem. We need to fix that. No!
Watch out, Carl!
What? I don't know what else.
Come here, bitch.
Damn it. It's so hard to react fast enough. Get him, Kara! I keep pressing the wrong buttons.
I say!
Yeah, Kara. I am so uncomfortable with that entire situation. Because that's not something that you can just... Oh my... Look at all those different options, possibilities that could have come of that. See, I personally haven't known anyone that had to deal with something like that. Well, it depends. The dude is already, like, he has anger issues and whatnot, but then he's a junkie as well. At least an alcoholic, to say the least. And I just can't imagine someone having to go through that. It's really sad. It's really sad. I really don't have anything else to say about it.
That was by far the most boring party I've been to in the last 25 years. Every time I go to one of these, I ask myself, what the hell am I doing here? I hate cocktail parties and all the schmoozers that go there.
Well, it's a chance for all those people who admire your work to meet you.
Yeah. No one gives a damn about art. All they care about is how much money they're gonna make out of it. Come on, let's have a drink. Oh, the excitement of this whole thing has made me thirsty.
Scotch, neat as usual?
Absolutely.
Okay, but you know what your doctor would say?
Yeah, well, he can kiss my ass. I'm old enough to choose my own medication. Did you leave the light on in the studio?
No, I'm sure I didn't.
Call the police.
Detroit Police, what's your emergency?
This is Carl Manfred's android at 8941 Lafayette Avenue. We've just returned home and found the lights on. There may have been a break-in.
A patrol car is on the way.
Let's go check it out. Marcus, no, I'm gonna come with you.
I don't want to take him. He's gonna end up getting hurt. No. Can I?
Leo! What are you doing?
You refuse to help me, so I'm helping myself. It's crazy what some people pay for this shit.
Don't touch them.
Look, they're all gonna be mine sooner or later anyway. Just think of it as a down payment on my inheritance.
Marcus, get him away from there. Get him out of here.
Listen, you should go before things get worse.
All you ever do is tell me to go away. What's wrong, Dad? Not good enough for you? Not perfect, like this fucking thing?
That's enough! Get out! Right now!
What makes it so special anyway, huh? What's it got that I don't...
Leave him alone!
Come on! Let's see what you got!
Marcus, don't defend yourself, you hear me? Don't do anything.
Go ahead, hit me. What you waiting for? Think you're a man? Act like one!
Stop it!
What's the matter, too much of a pussy?
Stop it, Leo! Stop it!
Just scared to fight back, you fucking bitch! Oh, right! that's right. I forgot you're not a real person. You're just a fucking piece of plastic.
No, Leo, leave him alone.
No. I'm gonna destroy you. Then it'll just be me and my dad. I'm gonna tear you apart, and nobody's...
Leo. Oh, my God. Leo. My little boy.
Carl, I...
They'll destroy you, Marcus. You gotta go. Get out of here.
Carl, I didn't mean to.
Get out! Now! Go! Marcus!
Don't fucking move!
I don't even know what to say. I'm making me putting me under the spotlight and making me choose a decision in such a short period of time. I chose my decisions in a panic. I wasn't able to clearly think things out. I don't know. I don't know why I chose what I chose to do. I mean, I chose to defend myself because, well, Leo's an asshole, but...
Why'd you kill him? What happened before you took that knife?
How long were you in the attic?
Why didn't you even try to run away?
Say something, goddammit! Fuck it. I'm out of here. We're wasting our time interrogating a machine. We'll get nothing out of it.
You could always try roughing up a little. After all, it's not human.
Androids don't feel pain. You would only damage it, and that wouldn't make it talk. Deviants also have a tendency to self-destruct when they're in stressful situations.
Okay, smartass. What should we do then?
I could try questioning it.
What do we have to lose? Go ahead. Suspect's all yours.
You're damaged. Did your owner do that? Did he beat you? I detect an instability in your program. It can trigger an unpleasant feeling, like fear in humans. I'm not going to hurt you. I just need to ask you some questions so we can understand what happened. If you won't talk, I'm going to have to probe your memory.
No! No, please don't do that. What? What are they gonna do to me?
They're going to disassemble you to look for problems in your bio components. They have no choice if they want to understand what happened.
Why did you tell them you found me? Why couldn't you just have left me there?
I was programmed to hunt deviants like you. I just accomplished my mission.
I don't want to die.
Then talk to me.
I can't.
Twenty-eight stab wounds. You didn't want to leave him a chance, huh? Did you feel anger? Hate? He was bleeding, begging you for mercy, but you stabbed him again and again and again.
Please, please leave me alone.
All right, all right. Everything is going to be okay. I understand how you felt. You were overcome by anger and frustration. No one can blame you for what happened. Okay then, don't talk. What do I care after all? I mean, I'm not the one accused of murder, right? If you remain silent, there's nothing I can do to help you. They're gonna shut you down for good. You'll be dead. Do you hear me? Dead.
He tortured me every day. I did whatever he told me, but there was always something wrong. Then one day, he took a bat and started hitting me. For the first time, I felt scared. Scared he might destroy me, scared I might die. So I grabbed a knife and I stabbed him in the stomach. I felt better. So I stabbed him again. And again, until he collapsed. There was blood everywhere.
The sculpture in the bathroom, you made it, right? What does it represent?
It's an offering. An offering so I'll be saved.
RA9. It was written on the bathroom wall. What does it mean?
The day shall come when we will no longer be slaves. No more threats. No more humiliation.
Why did you write, "I am alive," on the wall?
He used to tell me I was nothing. That I was just a piece of plastic. I had to write it. To tell him he was wrong.
The sculpture was an offering. An offering to whom?
To RA9. Only RA9 can save us.
RA9. Who is RA9? Why did you hide in the attic instead of running away?
I didn't know what to do. For the first time, there was no one there to tell me. I was scared. So I hid.
When did you start feeling emotion?
Before he used to beat me and I never said anything. But one day I realized it wasn't fair. I felt anger, hatred. And then I knew what I had to do.
I'm done.
Chris, lock it up.
All right, let's go.
Leave me alone! Don't touch me.
What the fuck are you doing?
You shouldn't touch it. It'll self-destruct if it feels threatened.
Stay out of this, got it? The fucking Andrew's gonna tell me what to do.
You don't understand. If it self-destructs, we won't get anything out of it.
I told you to shut your fucking mouth! Chris, gonna move this asshole or what?
I'm trying!
I can't let you do that! Leave it alone, now!
I warned you, motherfucker!
That's enough!
Mind your own business, Hank.
I said, that's enough.
You're not gonna get away with it this time.
Everything is all right. It's over now. Nobody's gonna hurt you. Please, don't touch it. Let it follow you out of the room, and it won't cause any trouble.
The truth is inside.
I'm not gonna lie. So far, the only thing I am not super fond of about this is how much it's jumping around. I'm sure it'll all come together later on. I mean, it gives you a date before every scene. But first thing that's popping to my head is, for one, it feels like I'm playing three different games. in one. Stemmed off of, you know, the same concept. And I, at the moment, have not really any good idea as to where they're trying to take it. The only thing in common that I've seen so far is, in terms of Android, whatever, is instability in their software and breaking their program and whatever. Don't get me wrong, I still love the game. I just, so much has happened between the three sections that I just don't know what to think at this point. I mean, you got Todd being an asshole, you got Leo being an asshole, and then you got whatever his name was being an asshole. You got Connor intervening, even though he wasn't breaking his program. You got Kara, which you didn't have to, but chose to break the program to protect Alice. And then you got Marcus defending himself, which resulted in him probably being dead now, because I made Marcus look like the freaking aggressor. I don't know. I mean, I guess we'll see what comes of it. I don't know what else to do. Or what else to think. Brain is shot. Too many emotions I'm thinking and thinking about and feeling at one time. So with that being said, I am going to leave it here for today's video. Thank you so much for watching, and I hope you all have a fantastic day or night, and as always, I'll see you all in the next video. Peace out.